Yo, what's up? In this video, I'm going to talk about charting of the Model 3 Standard Range Plus with the heat pump. So before we start, I'm going to show you now this screen. Lots of information. To the top left, we have the newest, that's the one we're looking for. 2021 Model 3 Standard Range Plus. I measured to have about 50 kilowatt hour. And then the next one there in the middle, roughly top, is then the previous model without heat pump, which actually charges faster. And then we have the ID3 on the top right corner. And again, I show you 56 kilowatt hour. It might be a little bit confusing, but on spec, it's 58 kilowatt hour. But just so you guys can have something to compare with in terms of battery size, I will use that one. And then on the bottom left here, we have E28. Again, the same there. I measured 45 kilowatt hour and 50 kilowatt hours and net cross capacity. And then eSol on the last one there. So 70 kilowatt hour is roughly what I estimate it is, in case, but you see that I actually didn't provide the gross capacity of the Model 3. I don't know how much it could be, maybe close to 60 kilowatt hour roughly. But also before we start, I want to explain why I chose these cars. ID3, I chose it because in a similar segment and similar price range as the Model 3 Standard Range Plus. E28 though, it's it depends how you spec it, but it's slightly cheaper than the two top cars. But the battery size is similar. I couldn't really find that many cars with around 50 kilowatt hour. And by the way, your ID3 actually has slightly larger battery than the Model 3, but they are comparable in range because the Model 3 is more efficient than ID3. And then the last one, the eSol, why the heck did they include that one? Because way bigger battery. Well, because the price on the eSol is also about the same as Standard Range Plus and ID3. So now you guys know why I included these four. So then, let me take a deep breath. Then we start the horse race. All right, so right off the bat, you see that Model 3 Standard Range Plus, the new one, is getting, it was speaking at 160 kilowatt, but then it already dropped to 140 kilowatt. But then also the same with the other Standard Range Plus, they only peak at the maximum speed for a little bit, but then they also drop. But you see that the previous Standard Range Plus actually goes faster than the current one. And then as for ID3 is now capped at 100 kilowatt. It will actually go 100 kilowatt for a little while. And then you see the E28 is then, initially it was at also 100 kilowatt, but for not very long. And now it's already down to 76 kilowatt. And then as for the eSol, it already hit the maximum speed of 72. Maximum speed is 75 kilowatt, but it's going to last for a little while. Now let's go back to the Standard Range Plus. What happened over there? You see that the new Standard Range Plus is then slower than the old one. It's like 10 kilowatt slower. So this is what we had to expect. That it's always like this. The Tesla will charge a little bit slower, but then eventually they're going to unlock the power. But at least you see that it has the potential to charge faster than today. Okay, ID3 now start throttling a little bit. We don't see 100 kilowatt already. We've already allowed to 37 kilowatt. And then for the E28 is almost at 40%, and it's still hovering at 76 kilowatt. That's pretty good. eSol, on the other hand, you know, remember the eSol has the biggest battery, so you can't compare them one-to-one in terms of battery, but you can compare them in terms of range at least. eSol will then have okay charging speed around there, but you see now that when you look at state of charge, you see that the Standard Range Plus, the old one, is actually leading with 62%. That's pretty amazing. And but then the other one, the new Standard Range Plus is at 50%, which is actually on a second place. Yeah, second place. So right now, the two Teslas are leading in terms of percentage. ID3, though, is now down to 74 kilowatt. As expected, when you reach 50%, you can't charge too far, too fast, too hard, too long, right? E28, though, is down to 52 kilowatt already. Oh, no, but it's already reached 55%, so that's pretty good. But it also has the smallest battery of these cars. eSol is still hovering at 42 kilowatt, 75 kilowatt at 42%. So eSol is now on it's the slowest one as for now. But remember, it has the biggest battery. What happens with the Tesla now? Tesla is now at 63. Oh, wow, look at that. The old Standard Range Plus is already at 75%. That's pretty amazing after just how many minutes now? Only 22 minutes, it's already at 76%. That's superb. And then, but the new one is slower. You see that the new one is slower, new Standard Range Plus, and then ID3. Also starts throttling a little bit now to 64%. So right now it's actually neck and neck with E28 and ID3. But again, it's not comparable because E28 has a smaller battery. But E28 is now down to 43 kilowatt. Ooh, that's not too good. Okay, if you look at eSol now, eSol is about to throttle. The throttle point, yeah, you see it happens a little bit now. The throttle point will usually happen around 55, 57. Yeah, there we go. 55%. The eSol is now down to only 57, 56 kilowatt. What happens with the Standard Range Plus? Back to the Tesla. Okay, but Standard Range Plus is already at 84%. 10% already, pretty massive lead there, just amazing. But you know that now it's starting to crawl a little bit, but remember that we are already at 85%, so of course it's not healthy to charge too fast. As for the new standard response, it's at 76%. Wow, it seems like actually ID3 is going to maybe catch up with the new standard response. We're going to see which one will be first. Well, we know the first one will be the old standard response, but which going to be number two, we don't know yet. Let's go back to E28, what's happening over there. Oh no, E28 is down to 27 kilowatt only. Oh no, that's not very fast compared to the other cars. What about eSol? eSol is now steady. Next breakpoint of the eSol will be about 73%, so we're going to come back to that one. Okay, standard response is now about to finish. 89%. Oh no, standard response finished after 34 minutes. So the old standard response is done. Now we're just looking at the battle now between the new standard range plus and the ID3. ID3 seems to be a little bit behind standard range plus, but standard range plus is now hovering at 27 kilowatt only, but the ID3 is hovering at charging at 47 kilowatt. That is pretty amazing. Very flat charging curve. What's happening with E28? E28 is also at 82%, but remember it's a small battery, so we just have it in the comparison. And then eSol is about to eSol about to trot now. Take a look at eSol. They're not on the way. Wait, it's gonna happen soon. Wait, okay. But let's not care about eSol. It goes too slow. there. There have the throttle roll. 74% is throttle point. Okay, which one now? Let's take a look at Sunrise Plus and ID3. Sunrise Plus, 70. Oh, this is really neck and neck. 88%. Which one could be first? But you see that ID3 is turning faster than the Sunrise Plus. ID3 might be able to win. 89%. ID3 is gonna take the lead. No, then you look at that. This is so even. ID3 and the Sunrise. Which one's gonna hit 90% first? There! ID3 was number two, and then standard range plus right behind it. So now we only have the battle between the E28 and the eSol. We have the two bottom cars. They are charging pretty slow. E28 had a pretty nice lead, but you see that right now E28 is charging at only 11 kilowatt, whereas eSol is charging at 24 kilowatt. So, but on the other hand, the eSol it has a very bigger battery. So right now it seems like the E28 is going to hit 90% before the eSol. There's really no way that the eSol will be able to catch that one. You see, we have eSol is so far behind, but again, way bigger battery and way more range, so it doesn't make too much sense to compare these two bottom cars. We only included them to compare with the top cars in terms of range or in terms of battery size. So you see, E28 is pretty slow now towards the bottom, only 10 kilowatts, so you probably wouldn't want to charge too long at those. Okay, right now there's not much going on, so there you go, E28 hit 100%, 90%, and then I guess there's really no point to look at the rest now. But you see that also the eSol charges fairly slow towards the end compared to, well, actually, I forgot to show you that the ID3 is actually still charging, and I forgot to focus on that one. But you will see that the ID3 goes really fast, even at 98%, is receiving 22 kilowatt. This is pretty good, but remember that the ID3 also has a fairly, it has a little top buffer, but I've seen that the German cars, they tend to charge really flat towards the end. But just wait and see until you see the iX3 charge. I would just say, e-tron, go home. But okay, that it will be covered in another episode. So you will see that this is pretty amazing that the ID3 can go to 100% before the eSol hits 90%. Yeah, how about that? Well, it's slightly smaller battery, but So actually, I feel like the eSol's battery tech is a little bit outdated. So it's about time that we see the new IONIQ 5 and the EV6 coming. And if you guys wondering, hey, when are you going to get IONIQ 5 and EV6? Well, who knows? I know. First, what will usually happen is that some German car journalists, or I don't know, some finance newspaper gets the car a long time before me, and then they make some videos about it. And then I might get the car after 7 months or half a year. Then I might get the car. That's how it is, unfortunately. Yeah. But okay, so interesting charging session wise. I should mention this video was about the Model 3 Standard Range Plus. So you did see that it charged slower than before. It's the same size of battery, but it's charging slower. And this is what I've seen over and over again with other Teslas also, which is that they release the car, and then they are gathering data, and then they can just, after Tesla is more confident of what this battery can take, then they usually unleash more power. And I've been talking about this over and over again. I've seen it with the 90 pack that came out in 2015 or something. They also increased the speed on that one, on the 100 pack. Also, even in the old days, Model 3 only charged at maximum 120 kilowatt, and then eventually they unlock more power, you see. And this is not something unique with Tesla. Remember you heard the rumors that the ID.3 was a big battery pack. Right now it supports 125 kilowatts, but eventually rumors say that Volkswagen will unlock 170 kilowatts. So, you know, does it mean that Tesla owners, they are just beta testers? What about Volkswagen? What about other car manufacturers? They also tend to do some of the same, or other car manufacturing like BMW, they probably just test everything first, and then when they release the car, it's already charging pretty fast. So this is depending on which car manufacturer, what they choose to do. So what should I say then about the Model 3 then? Well, it charges slower, but chances are, I'm not going to guarantee anything, but it's the probability is there that Tesla will up the speed so it becomes as fast as the old one. I mean, why shouldn't it charge as fast as the old one, right? Right? So anyway, I think that's going to be it for now. I hope you enjoy the horse race. So thank you for watching, and talk to you later.